Hi, my name is Frané Lessac, and I'm here to share a very special book with you. Some of you might remember it as The Little Island, or some of you as My Little Island, but it's all about Montserrat. So I'm going to read the story because it's a very special story. It's my very first book. And it starts off, my best friend Luke and I are going to visit the island where I was born. From the air, it looks like a giant green turtle swimming in the sea. When our plane lands, we see dozens of smiling faces welcoming us. It's good to be back home. On the way to my aunt's house, we see dozens of brightly painted houses. From the road, they look like little rainbows sitting on the hills. As we drive up a mountainside, a breeze begins to blow. It smells so sweet. Luca wants to know the names of all the trees and flowers. I only know some of them. Frangipani and jasmine flowers, yellow pui and red flamboyant trees, pink coral and sweet bayram trees. My aunt has lunch ready for us when we arrive. It's too hot to cook indoors, so she cooks outside in old coal pots. My cousins and I gobble up pumpkin soup, pigeon peas, goat water stew, red snapper fish, and fried bananas topped with guava ice cream. Luca makes a funny face, but he eats it all. After lunch, lots of children come to play with us. Donkeys and goats and cats and dogs and birds and cows are everywhere. We even see giant iguanas that are 3 feet long and barking frogs called mountain chickens. Luca and I laugh. Who will believe us back home? To market, my aunt sings out early the next morning. When we get to town, the sun is just peeking up over the mountaintops. But people from nearby villages are already arriving by bus, by foot, by donkey. And on their heads, many people balance baskets on their heads, loaded with cinnamon and fresh nutmeg and other good things to sell. What do mangoes, what do nuts, people ask. They want to know the price before they buy. Luke and I can't decide what to get. Soursops, guavas, Christophines, mangoes, or juicy orange pawpaws. Which will taste the best? By noontime, it's way too hot to sit outside and walk around. And even the noisy traffic has stopped. And we eat all the fruits we bought at the market. After lunch, Luke and I duck into an island shop to buy presents for everyone back home. We choose mango jam, guava cheese, lime squash, and some very hot pepper sauce for Luca's dad. Oh, I miss that hot pepper sauce myself. The next day, we take a walk along the seashore. Fathers and sons are rowing brightly painted wooden boats with names like Frangelica, Annie Panny, and Shona Bee. They catch mackerel fish, parrot fish, tuna fish, trunk fish, and Picasso fish in their huge nets. When their boats are filled with flipping and flopping fish, they row back to shore. A fisherman blows a conch shell. People hear the toodle-toodle and run to the beach to buy nice fresh fish for their supper. The afternoon is hot, hot, hot. Luke and I dive into the sea and spend hours snorkeling in the cool underwater world. On Friday, I take Luca to see my old school. The teacher lets us stay and listen to folk tales and play games with wooden beads on the board. We make new friends, Sylvester, Desmond, Sylvia, Glendina, and Althea. We promise Mrs. O'Gara to write to the class. We won't forget. And almost everywhere we go, calypso and reggae music plays sweetly to our ears. Luca thinks it's neat that the steel drums are made from empty oil cans. We hear their rhythms echo all over the island. Music, sweet music. My island has its own volcano. Sometimes it sends puffs of smoke and fire into the air. I wonder what it would look like if it ever erupted. But I wouldn't want to be nearby if it did. I painted this years before the volcano erupted. Not far from the volcano is a wild, wild forest where we go fishing. We don't want to scare the fish, so we stand there quietly and just listen to the bird songs and frogs and insects and the sound of the bubbling mountain stream. Ding dong, ding dong. Today's my cousin's wedding. Luke and I ring the church bells as hard as we can to let everyone know Yanni and Sirietta are getting married. Then we go to my aunt's house for a big party. On the night before we go home, we get to stay up late. It's carnival! Jump up! Jump up! Our toes barely touch the ground as we dance to the carnival songs played all night long. When morning comes, our visit to my little island is over. Luke and I don't want to say goodbye to my aunts and cousins and all our friends. We just say, we'll come back soon. And I hope to come back soon too. I love this book and I love Montserrat. Enjoy.